Hi, my name is Mithuna and I'm a PhD student studying physics, and today I'm going to be chatting with Alice about quantum mechanics.
If you were to throw an apple towards the wall, what do you think is going to happen?
It would knock the wall down because these aren't wide enough.
Okay, that's a good point. Let's make these a little wider. But what happens if it goes like that? Where do you think it's going to go?
It's going to keep going.
Yeah.
Hit the wall and stop.
You want to put a mark where it stops?
Probably be somewhere around here.
Awesome. Cool. And what about if it went through this door instead?
Somewhere around here.
Yeah, great. So what about if, like, instead of an apple or a tennis ball, you had something like really, really small? Do you still expect like the same thing would happen?
Unless it could get through the wall, because it's so small.
That's a good point. Let's say that it can't. That's a really good point.
I'd say it would, but you're asking the question, so maybe it's not gonna.
All right, awesome. So let's say that we replace this apple. All right, so can you tell me what an atom is?
Everything is made up of atoms. It's really, 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 really small.
Right, can you see one with your eyes?
No.
Right, but if you had a setup like this, then the atoms, you wouldn't be able to see where they go, right? Like which path they go on, but
they could end up anywhere.
Yeah, why do you think they could end up anywhere?
Because it's so small.
Yeah, but let's say we throw the atoms so that if they do get through, then they definitely will hit the wall somewhere, so they don't like stop anywhere. But we're not gonna be able to see where they end up, right? Because like they're too small. But how about, there's some special paint that you can put on this wall. And this kind of paint, when an atom touches it, or like a particular type of atom touches it, it like lights up bright green. So let's say we are gonna fire this atom. Where do you think it might end up? Do you wanna put a green dot where you think it could go? Then when people actually decided to do this experiment, the way that they did it was like, first they put something here to block this door. So then which door does the atom go through? Right, and so then where should it end up?
Around there.
Yeah, exactly. And that's exactly what they got. So they weren't surprised by that. And then they did the same experiment, but they blocked this door instead. So where do you think the atoms went? Awesome. And so that's what happened. But what was really surprising was when they had both of the doors open at the same time, what do you think should happen?
It could go through either of the doors, but...
Yeah. But like you said, it has to have gone through one of the doors, right? And so this is what you expect. But when scientists actually did this experiment, they got a result that was completely crazy. Sort of like that. Does that look right?
Well, maybe because it's open, they start to head towards that one because it's still open.
So you think that maybe atoms can go in like curved paths, unlike the tennis balls?
Well, they can make up everything so they can be in whatever position they like.
Right, but don't you think that they would still have to follow the same rules as everything else?
But if it's just one atom, then it doesn't. It can go in a curved path as well.
Yeah, why do you think so?
Maybe because there's nothing for it really to sort of hold on to.
Yeah, okay.
So you think that the apple goes in a straight line because it's getting sort of held on to?
Because you've pushed it.
Yeah.
So I think that, like, you can do a similar sort of thing with the atom, right? You can, like, have a sort of atom gun, if you will, and you shoot the atom gun and then the atom has some momentum, then should sort of go straight. And so if that was the case, you would expect it to sort of end up in like these two groups, but it didn't happen. And so then you do have to say something crazy was happening, right? So maybe it is that the atoms for some reason go in loops, or the thing that quantum physicists hypothesized was that somehow, even though atoms can't split, that it was somehow going through both of the doors. So an apple can only go through one of the doors. But imagine if somehow instead, like the apple could become two apples and then go through both of the doors. What could it do that would change its path?
And then it would meet back up in the middle.
Yeah, right. And so it could do that, and then could like hit itself, do weird things like that. Yeah. Maybe there's somehow like two versions of the atom and it's doing both of those things. So that's a really crazy hypothesis, right? Like, so their hypothesis is if there's more than one thing that an object could be doing, then it would do both of them, right? But okay, what happens if we put someone here and they have some sort of special equipment that will let them detect if an atom goes through, right? And then someone else watching here, what do you think that they'll see? Like, do you reckon they'll see an atom going through both of them at the same time?
Well, if it's split up, then it's not an entire atom. They just see what atom's mm-hmm. made up of.
Yeah, exactly. But that's, again, somehow not what happens, which is really weird. Like, that's exactly what you'd think would happen. But the person here sees a whole atom go through, and the person here doesn't see any atom. So it looks like that atom went through this door. But then where do you think that atom would end up?
So
it ended up there.
So that's what you might expect. But what happens is the atom that went through this door ends up sort of around here. Mm-hmm. And then
when you're measuring it, it doesn't do the same thing as it would if you...
Yeah, exactly. Which is really weird. Like, why are atoms shy? Why do they care whether people are watching? So they only do both of the things if no one's watching. But if someone is watching, then they just do one of them. And then they do what you expect. So that's really weird. I was really happy with how that experiment went, especially when Alice asked all those questions, because it clearly showed that she understood things, but also that she was willing to ask when she didn't understand things. I think what's great about children is that they're willing to show that they don't understand. And a problem that we all have as adults is that we try to pretend that we know more than we do, and this stops us from learning.